Congratulations on completing your year in the USA. You've made new friends.
You've had many new experiences. You've created new memories.
And now it's time to share those experiences with your families and friends back home.
We hope you had a wonderful year.
Thanks for being a part of Ayusa.
Buenos tardes. Konnichiwa. Buongiorno.
Guten Tag. And good afternoon. My name is Rachel Hill, and I've had the honor of being a student ambassador for the Houston Ayusa Exchange Program this past year. Becoming a student ambassador happened rather unexpected for me. It began when Gaia, at the time a stranger, but now my exchange sister, entered the Westside High School Dean's Office. I had happened to be working in that very office as a student helper, and the dean asked me to show Gaia around the school. Throughout the next few weeks, we continued to hang out and grow a friendship. When circumstances arose that led to Gaia having to find a new home and the possibility of one outside of Texas, I was quick to ask my parents to bring her into our own home. From that came not only a friendship, but a sisterhood by choice. Through this, I came to know Sandra and the other CRs and exchange students. It was evident to me that something was different about spending time with the exchange students versus the common American friends I had. These students that sit before us today all had a willingness to experience new things. They had bravery and courage as they flew on a plane to America alone, to live in a house with people they did not know, speaking a language that was not usual for them, to attend a school they didn't have any friends at. Each student here plays an important part in making the Houston Ayusa Exchange Program unique by providing diversity within our communities. Experiencing this diversity has made my desire greater to go outside my own country's borders in order to travel to new places for new experiences. Through the Houston Exchange students, I have grown the desire to travel for new experiences at new places. Through the Houston Exchange students, I have grown to desire to countries such as Germany, Brazil, Denmark, the Netherlands, and Spain, just to name a few. To begin my cultural experience, I will have the privilege of spending 3 weeks in Italy this summer to visit Gaia and the rest of the Tomasi family. I look forward to experiencing the exchange students' various cultures, just as they have experienced my own American culture. Over the course of the year, we were able to experience the Texan lifestyle by taking part in a trail ride in riding horses, thanks to Aria's host family for opening up their ranch for our enjoyment. We learned about space at the NASA Space Center and grew closer as friends as we rode roller coasters in Kima. And although I was not able to attend, many of you traveled to San Antonio to participate in the Battle of the Flowers Parade. Even when we didn't plan a trip to a special location, we still made time for each other at sleepovers and private gatherings. At the beginning of the school year, people from all over the world came together in the United States to create a unique relationship unlike any other. We started as strangers who had some difficulty communicating. We then grew to become friends who embraced our differences and shared them with each other. Finally, we ended as a family who enjoyed every minute we got to spend together. The time we spent together was full of fun and laughter and will always be cherished memories. As we go our separate ways, graduates, remember that we may be miles apart, but we will always be close in heart.
I've never been the one to raise my hand. That was not me, and now that's who I am. Because of you, I am standing tall. My heart is full of endless gratitude. You were the one, the one to guide me through. I believe guess I've learned to question is to grow. That you still have faith is all I need to know. I've learned to love myself in spite of me, and I've learned to walk the road that I believe. But the only question with me now is, do I make you proud? Stronger than I've ever been now. Never be afraid.
What can I say that hasn't already been said? What can I tell you that you haven't already heard from us or the ones before us? Our experiences were surely different. Our journeys were certainly not the same. But somehow, our path has always seemed to cross at the end, and we all find ourselves changed. Change is what some fear and others look forward to. It's what we often can see in ourselves, but that others can see in us. I can't speak on behalf of everybody here, and I can't tell your stories, but I can tell mine. When writing speeches like this, nobody wants to be seen as arrogant, and nobody knows where the fine line between pride and vanity is. Although many would disagree, I don't think of myself as boastful, but I do take pride in the positive changes I noticed in myself this year. Positive changes I can summarize with three adjectives I believe I earned this year. Number one is strong. Strong is for every time I overcame something I never thought I could. It's for every time I replaced a tear with a smile and kept going forward. Some of my best memories are from this year, but so are some of my worst. As an exchange student, I rarely go a day without facing a challenge. Some are easier than the others. But I recently reacquainted myself with two particular verses from the Quran that spoke so profoundly to me and to the hurdles I faced. They go as follow: with hardship comes relief, and God does not burden a soul beyond what it can bear. I am not a religious person, but after spending almost 10 months here, these quotes spoke to my heart, and maybe they'll speak to yours. Number two is grateful and appreciative. As a teenager, you sometimes feel entitled, and you fail to see the difference between what is a given right and what is a privilege. I would like to thank my host family for helping me see that, and apologize to my biological family for not coming to this realization earlier. Every chore I've done this year or watched one of my host siblings do has been a painful reminder of every time my mom, sisters, and father helped clean or cook while I watched TV or read a book. I would like to apologize to my mother, who, like every mother here, works more than 8 hours a day and then comes back home to do her second shift, which is taking care of the house. She never complains, never acts like a victim, doesn't perceive herself as a hero, even though she's the most heroic person I know, doesn't tell her story, even though it deserves to be told. Like every mother in this room, she deserves more. Therefore, I am determined to show more appreciation and help more as I go back home, because I can't fix the past, but I sure can improve the future. Number three is responsible. Before coming here, I considered myself pretty responsible and independent, even though I relied on my parents to do most things for me. Here, not only do I have to be financially responsible and limit myself to a budget, which I have never done before, but I am most and foremost responsible of representing my country well and building a bridge of understanding between two drastically different cultures. If that's not challenging and stressful enough, let's say that the country that I have to represent is undergoing major political tensions and economical struggles, and of which the majority of the people follow the Islamic faith. To what we add in some factors, such as an international war against terrorism and a developing hate for Muslims. Now, imagine spending several months trying to replace a tarnished image with a simply more accurate one, which is, of course, more positive than the one you are most likely to see in the news. Then it all goes to waste when a terrorist attack strikes your country, but somehow some still think it's your country's fault. Now you're faced with questions such as, why are you doing this? Why are people terrorists? And one of my favorites, can you just tell them to stop? Because for some reason, they just assume that I can just hit up their phones and be like, yo, terrorist, Habibi, what you're doing is not cool, man. Like, you should really stop. Peace. And of course, you can't react to that to those unfortunate questions by showing sadness because you don't want to victimize yourself. But you can't show anger because you don't want to reinforce the stereotypes concerning your people. So all you can do is repeat the same process all over again and try to explain to people who sometimes refuse to understand that most of us, no matter what faith we belong to, what ethnicity we're part of, that we're not that different from you, and that the actions of the few don't reflect the heart and the essence of the many. Although discouraging, it hasn't pushed me or others like me to give up. And that taught us perseverance. These three words describe only some of the changes I went through during this journey. And now I am going back to my home country, where I will be starting a new adventure and answering questions such as, how was your vacation? Or, are you a cowgirl now? Or, is bacon as good as they say? I would like to take this opportunity to thank my host family, who made this journey 100% better. I thank you for every family activity, every Sunday dinner, every movie night, and every trip. I thank you for opening your home for two foreign kids and not killing us for our constant criticism of your love for ancient horror movies. I don't know if I can call them horror movies. I thank you for bearing with my lame puns, obviously, and hilarious jokes, and for being my home away from home. Now, I will be reading a poem I wrote that our beloved Sandra, who did an amazing job organizing all of this, asked me to read. It's called A Journey. When I was 1 minute old, God was whoever my mom thanked as she held me for the first time. When I was 2 years old, God was a word I often heard but not quite understood. When I was 5 years old, God was whoever put me in my mom's belly, according to my kindergarten teacher who told me that as I asked her, where do babies come from? When I was 6 years old, my first grade teacher told me that I was Muslim, and God was now Allah. When I was 8 years old, God was whoever I followed out of fear. He was the merciful and the almighty. When I was 10 years old, God was whoever I needed to believe in just so I can belong. When I was 12 years old, God was whoever I turned to when things went wrong. He was the hope I craved. He was the right in all what was gone wrong. When I was 14 years old, God was an idea I questioned, a dream that raised all my unanswered queries. And now I'm 16 years old, and I'm not sure who God is. Is he Yahweh, Jesus, Allah, Brahman, or is he not one but many? Is he the one I hear in my grandmother's voice as she opens the doors to her home and her heart? Or the one in the extremist's howl as he let go of his anger and hate? Is he the one I saw in my friend's eyes as she invited me to church for the first time? Or the one in that invader's mind as he tries to spread the dreadful peace for the millionth time? Is he the one in my mother's dreams or the one in her tears? I don't know what the answer is, and I'm not here to preach, but I'm here to tell you a story of a girl who's tired. Tired of watching the news and seeing an attack after the other, hearing a scream after the other, a cry for help after the other. Tired of people claiming they know they want change when they keep making the same mistakes. Tired of people trying to achieve peace by declaring war and to teach love by spreading hate. Tired of people claiming to know the one true answer when they all answer the same question differently. We all have different journeys, and we all have different stories. But this is a story of a girl who's still seeking an answer, who's still trying to make her own path, and who's still hoping for a glimmer of light at the end of the tunnel. This is my story, and I'm looking forward to hearing yours.
It's 7:10 a.m. in the morning. I wake up, make myself some sandwiches for lunch, eat some cereals, check what's up on social media, and then grab my bike and ride to school. So, it's 6:25 a.m. in the morning. I wake up, realize I'm too late to do anything I want, grab some Pop-Tarts out of the pantry, run outside to catch the school bus while seven horses are just seeing me run like a maniac. I guess y'all can imagine which one of these two mornings my morning here is and which one in Germany. I'm a city kid. I came from a place with a population of 1.8 million people and got placed in Sealy, Texas, which has a population of 6,000. So my life has completely changed. I mean, I used to live in a 200-square-foot apartment with my mom, and now suddenly I live on a 20 acres land together with more animals than I can even count. When my mom first heard that I'm going to spend my exchange year in Sealy, in Texas, she was very worried. All she could think of when she heard Texas was guns, hats, boots, horses, and fast food. She wasn't wrong. But in fact, it's not a bad thing. I learned to love Texas and its people. Texas has wonderful people. People have made me laugh, cry, feel foreign, and feel like home at the same time. I appreciate all those people. I mean, 10 months ago, I was as far away from a country boy as I could possibly be. And now, 10 months later, I can proudly say I'm the most foreign cowboy you can ever meet. And that would have never happened without my wonderful host parents, Lynn and Thurston Yazell. I want to thank you very much, and also my host brother TJ for not killing me after I asked some questions too many times. But there is no doubt I will miss all of this. I'll miss waking up in the sound of chickens. I'll miss eating Whataburger with friends. I'll miss Friday night football games, and most definitely I will miss riding horses till it gets dark outside. At the same time, I know that I have a home across the world here that I can always return to. And so, guys, if that ain't country, then I don't know. Thank you. And I want to say a big thank you to the best CRs in the world, Sandra and Martin. And I want to give you all this. Thank you all so much for being there for us.
We are coming close to the end of the exchange year. I still can't believe that I am going to leave here soon. Being here and experience different culture, different lifestyle, and different language have changed my perspective of my life. I gained a lot of things more than I expected. Do you still remember when I came here? You packed your suitcase, say goodbye to your friends and family, and got on a plane to fly away from your home. I still remember my feelings when I got on plane. I was so nervous and I couldn't eat anything. Even they have my favorite ice cream for snacks.
I kept thinking, what should I say when I meet my host family, and I practiced it over and over again. But unfortunately, when I saw my host family, I forgot everything that I tried to say, and I couldn't only smile. When we were in the car, my host dad asked me, what do you want to eat for first meal in America? And I said, McDonald's. I don't know why I said that, because I don't like Macs, but McDonald's. But I was too nervous to think everything, and I couldn't be confident on my English at all. First few months were really hard for me to understand everything. What do you want to drink? My answer was yes. What do you need for school? I said yes. I couldn't even tell if they were asking me a question or not. I have never had a difficult time to talking with people in my life. Making friends, studying at school, and communicating with people, I was good at these things in my home country, Japan. But here, everything was difficult. I don't know how many times I was frustrated by my lack of understanding of English. And there was a time when I was scared of talking English and making mistakes. And I didn't want to do anything except to sleeping and eating. American food and snack helped me a lot. Maybe that's why I gained my weight. But best things that made me think that I want to speak English more and help me a lot was my host family. When I talk with them, even can speak English as well. I enjoy talking and I was very happy. My host family and I love to gather at the table and have a conversation about each other. The more I talk with them and I know them, the more I think I wish I could speak English more. I really like to talk, especially with my mom, with my host mom. I have never shared my feeling with someone this much. She's my awesome advisor and made me realize the importance of sharing my feelings with people. My host dad, he's always making jokes, and it makes me laugh and happy. And I love eating what he cooks, and it gave me a lot of energy. And Rebecca, she's my host sister. She's very smart and funny, loud, sometimes mean and rude, but really kind and supportive. She's younger than me, but I have never felt she's my younger sister. She has been such a good influence to me. She speaks great English, and I am always jealous of her. If I were able to speak English like her, I wonder how much it would be fun to talk with her about Vampire Diaries and Riverdale, like everything. She's a great motivator for me to study English, and I can't imagine this year without my host family. Because of them, I could make a good friends and talk with them without boring my broken English, and I knew that I'm happy when I could express what I wanted to say. Now, I almost finished my exchange year, but I will keep studying English hard, and I want to improve my English more. There are always going to be difficulties in my life, but I feel like this experience can make me grow up stronger and become a better person. Both bad and good things made it possible for this year to be amazing. And now I have second family and good friends who understand me, and I really appreciate everyone who supported me. Thank you so much.
I didn't fall twice, so that's something. So after all these sentimental and sad things, I'm the clown of the situation, so I don't have a speech, but I came up with this idea, and Sandra helped me, and Henrika and Sandra's family. I wanted to give each one of our students, of the students graduating, a certificate that was supposed to be funny or like real about their overall experience and of the memories that we've shared. So Madison is going to help me hand out the certificates. So if you could actually get up, like stand up when I call your name, please. So these are going to be most likely to and most blank to, you know, have a memory, a funny memory. So our first one goes to, our first one is most likely to survive a tornado. This is for Aria. You can clap. This is for one of the students that have embraced as Aria, almost more than him, the country and the Texas culture. And this goes to Nick, and it's most likely to move to Texas and own its own ranch. This is from one of our memories that we have all together as a group. And it was, I think, one of the first one of the first big events where we all got together and played games and ate together. And this is most likely to cheat at capture the flag. And this goes to Luca for the people that weren't there. We played capture the flag, and we were in two teams. And Luca was tall, and he hid the flag, but on top of buildings. So,
best team out there.
Yeah. This goes to a student that has played, has embraced the high school American culture, and has played at least three sports that I know in high school here in America. And this goes to Leticia, as most athletic. Okay, this is personal. I asked Sandra for the permission before doing this because I didn't want it to be too personal. This is most likely to be grounded. And this goes out to Henry. It's not serious, don't worry. This goes to our girl that talks a lot, more than me actually, which is hard to achieve, and gets mad at the American health system sometimes when she gets sick. And this is most outspoken, and it goes to Rebecca. Now, for this, we have two because we thought it was right to give to both students. This is most improved in English, and we're giving them to Nao and Lily. So, congrats. This is for a fashion lover. It's most likely to spend all their money, their monthly budget, on clothes, and this goes to Enrica. This is for a food lover, and it's most likely to spend all their money on food, and it's for Hanny. This next one was given me... the suggestion was given me by her sisters and family, and this is most likely to raise a kid that will become an exchange student in the U.S., and this goes to Lika. Now, this student, unluckily I didn't get to know that well, so I had to ask around, and people have told me that she likes social gatherings. So this next one is most likely to be featured on a celebrity news outlet, and it goes to Kim. And this is our last student, and this is most likely to become, to be the first woman. Well, if you don't know her, you don't know that she uses the word colonize and recolonize a lot. And this is most likely to be the first woman to colonize the United States, and this goes to Russia. Now, I've done, they might not know, but I've did these award certificates for the CRs too. And they're a little funny and might hit, might be mad a little bit, but it's okay. It's graduation. So this happens, I mean, now it won't happen anymore, but it used to happen when we used to share at home, and it's most likely to be mistaken as a current exchange student. And this goes to Zem. Sean, please don't be mad at me. I didn't choose this. They told me I didn't. It's not my fault. It's the girl's fault. And this is. I'm sorry. This is most likely to cheer for the losing NFL team. Congrats. That wasn't me. They just told me. This goes to someone that has provided us with yummy barbecue at our gatherings. And this is Best Chef, and it goes to Martin. This next one, too, her daughters told me to write this. I don't know why. I've never experienced this, but apparently it has happened. And it's most likely to freak out in the car. And it goes out to Sandra. And the last one, this has happened a few times, and it's actually almost every time. But we still love you. It's okay. It's most likely to be late at every single Ayusa event. And it goes out to April.
I have eight.
Yeah, she has eight kids and a lot of cats, dogs too. So it's okay. So that was it. I just wanted to make it a little fun and not only sad and emotional speeches. So now back to a speech. Thank you.
I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. Always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears, but never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain. And it's so hard to say goodbye, but yesterday's gone, we gotta keep moving on. I'm so thankful for the moment, so glad
I'll keep like a photograph and hold you in my heart forever.
I don't want to be the negative one, but sad the happiness is over again. We have to go back to the emotional part. So when Sandra asked me if I wanted to give a speech, I wasn't sure if I wanted to too, because like I'm not good at speeches and I really don't like this. But this year has been about trying new things, so that's what I did. That's what probably everyone did in this room, like for especially the exchange students. like we've been getting outside our comfort box and all that stuff, all this year has been about trying new things and adjusting to another lifestyle, and that's what like a year makes unforgettable and special for most of y'all. And this year is something that no one will ever like take away from you. This is something you take with you for the rest of your lives, and you can be proud of that. Like, you did this, no one else did it for you. It hasn't been always easy. Everyone needed some help always, but you always knew you could fall back to your host families. So I want to give a special thank you to all the host families that are here today. You certainly made this year like special for everyone. Like you opened your homes and your families for the people sitting here in front of me, and I think everyone should be thankful for doing it, for y'all doing that. Because of y'all, we were like able to follow our dreams and come to America to, like what people say, live the American dream. And yeah, y'all like. The host families will always be like in our hearts. Like everyone sitting here will always be remembered. So like even in 30 years, we will think back about these moments that like y'all did for us. So back to the CRs, I wanna ask like one of my CRs to come up here. Please.
Thank you.
it.
So, like, we want to thank you because we know y'all's lives are so busy. Y'all have a, y'all work. You have to be CRs. You have to arrange trips for everyone. And we know you don't have to arrange those trips, but y'all do that so we can have another experience. So thank you for that. As the host families, y'all will always be remembered by us. Like, y'all did a really good job, and for the coming years, y'all will, like, keep doing that, I hope. y'all have big impacts on our lives. Y'all, like, made us feel welcome. Like, America was scared, and for me, it was scared for the first day, but everyone here sitting in front of us, like, in this room, all our friends, families, I want to give credit to all the host families and friends sitting here for pushing us to strive for greatness and prepare us for, like, the rest of our lives, because, like, this is just 1 year. Like, the difficult parts still have to come when you turn 18 and all that stuff. Not only did you, like, apply education to us, but you also made us to human beings, and yeah. As the class of 2017 graduates today, we want you to know that your impact and influence has contributed to the achievements of every single member of the graduated class. Today we cry that this amazing chapter of our life ended, but tomorrow we will smile that so many doors has opened for us again. Like, as I said before, like, America was really scary the first time. So, like, I didn't know anything about the country. I didn't know how it worked, or how the schools were, how the people were. But every host family, all the people we've met, like, showed us, like, the difference. Like, America's amazing. You say everything is better in Texas, and it's kind of true. Like, and our friends, they all got us through the experience of high school. They helped us survive the long nights and the early mornings. They helped us navigating through the school, and for most of us, most of the time, it looked like a maze. Like, the schools are big. But most importantly, they taught us how to be ourselves as a person and the person we were trying to be. Some of y'all, like, I don't know all of you, like, as good as everyone else. Like, yeah. But I want you to know that, like, y'all mean, like, a lot to me. Like, y'all made this year. Oh my.
Go for it.
This should have been sandals. Like, we made friendships for life, and we'll always remember everyone. Oh, God.
Sorry.
And, like, I hope one day we can, like, all come back to America or, like, visit each other's, like, I'll probably go to Germany for sure because that's so close. And like, you'll see me back in America in like 2 years. So when I have the money. So you don't have to do this, but like, if you can, but like, if you go home today, go call your friends and everything. Say them you're thankful for this year. Tell them how much you appreciate their help around the school year, especially the first few weeks in high school. Wasn't easy. Like, the language barriers and just the way everything goes different in the United States. Like, this is kind of my end of my speech, so. So, how do I bedank that? And like, if everyone, like, all the graduates can come up to stage, or that way, I'll rise. Thank you.
First, we have Rebecca Amstmink. She's from the Netherlands. Rasha Ben Killany from Tunisia. Henry Chu from Taiwan. Leticia Ichorn from Germany. Luca Gidica from Germany. From Germany. Henrika Kurinsari from Finland. Lika Okiyoshi from Japan. Aria Semavadi from Germany.
We put them there. You're welcome.
Kim Siemens from the Netherlands. Gaia Tomasi from Italy. Nick Rabet from the Netherlands. Now Watanabe from Japan. And lastly, Lily Wong from Hong Kong. Graduates, if you're wondering what the funny-looking strings hanging from your graduation caps are, it's called a tassel. The word for tassel originated from the word tasseu, which translated from Latin refers to the clasp of the neck of a garment. In the beginning, tassels served as a weaved knot in garments to prevent unraveling. Then, over the course of time, they took on a more powerful significance. They were worn by ancient priests and military officers. A tassel became a symbol of power and prestige. Only in the past 50 years have tassels been used on the graduation cap. The tassel was originally designed to decorate the graduation cap during the ceremony, but it has come to have a symbolism as well. The gesture of moving the tassel from one side of the cap to the other symbolizes the individual's movement from a student to graduate. Prior to the ceremony, the tassel is expected to be worn on the right. During the ceremony, it will be moved to the left side after every student has received their diploma. So, as one final act, as a whole, before we go our separate ways, graduates, will you please move the tassel from the right side of your cap to the left? Way to go, graduates. This does conclude our graduation, Ayusa Class of 2017 graduation ceremony. Thank you for all the host families, friends, and exchange students for attending. And thank you to Sandra for planning it.